Good morning. Oh, did you see that? Well, you could have done if you turned your head round, because this is a 3D camera. No, it's not. It's a 360-degree camera, that's it. Slightly different. Anyway, always at the bleeding edge of new technology, Angry goes 360. So, the thing about 360 cameras is it doesn't really matter where you put them down, because you're going to be able to see everywhere anyway. So it's really weird. So you can just, like, there's no framing or no composing, and they take stills as well. So if you're going to take a still, then, like, for example, you can, if you look over there, there's a load of scaffolding up. It looks like they're going to extend that bungalow up one floor, so you wouldn't have seen that normally. And we're coming up to the village shop. The downside is I've got to keep it very snappy, because 1 minute of this 360 video to stitch it all together, render it and everything, takes about, I don't know, it's about 15 to 1. So you won't find very many 360 degree videos that are more than a few minutes in length. And that's just because we don't have the processing power at the moment to handle the output that's generated. But you can record it and store it so that in the future, you know, when we've got much faster computers, a lot of this stuff will be able to be archived. Anyway, look up here, I'm coming up to the shop. This is my shop, and there's a parking space out the front, which is good. So I'm going to pull in here and then turn the camera off, because that's a minute and a half, and that's about as much as you get. All right, see you in a minute. This is what I'm talking about. You see this thing here is a ad hoc sort of tractor platform thingy with sides, which is being towed by a tractor. And it's they come out every time, the same time every day, and we just get stuck behind them, which is fair enough. You know, I suppose they're doing the job. It's 8 o'clock, so they must just be clocking on, and they take it to a field, whatever field it is, and then they put all the stuff in. It's doing a good job of trimming the roadside, as you can see. They take all the workers there in it, and then they put all the produce in it, bring the produce home and the workers, and it acts as like a temporary shelter if it starts raining, you know. So you can see it's very well kept. Now, I think it's when they're picking cauliflowers, because I think the tractor's got these sort of things on the side that pick cauliflowers. Anyway, this is why sometimes I have a slow drive to work. Right, dropped off something en route to work. Onwards and upwards. A bit of trenchant criticism for today. I'm going to go back to the LDC, the Annual Conference of Local Dental Committees, the sort of annual jamboree where they just all get pissed and treat each other to hospitality at their own expense, at the expense of their members. And you'll never believe what groundbreaking thing they've resolved at this year's Annual Conference of Local Dental Committees, and that is that they want VAT abolished on AEDs, automatic external defibrillators. You didn't hear it here first. This has been in the dental press. I don't know why it wasn't lead story on News at 10 or BBC News, but apparently Annual Conference of Local Dental Committees, of all the problems in dentistry, have decided that VAT on defibrillators is the lead. So, what are they going to say? VAT defibrillator, £1,000, £200. They want to save £200. They don't. They're not that worried about incomes, pay freezes, fees. Have to go around corners carefully, because this camera's not really secured all that well at the moment. Anyway, LDC, just remember, had a lot of promise. Independent committee, could have been brilliant. Could have had it all, but neutered by the BDA, who insist on doing their admin and organising their conference, and as a result, make sure they never come to anything. All right. That's it. Have to keep it to under a minute. Or two. Here we go. Coming into work. This is not the sort of work. It's not the sort of surgery that you'd expect, is it? For most people. Imagine. That's it over there. I don't know how this 360 footage is going to turn out. It's probably going to be a disaster. Probably going to be a great disaster. What's he doing with these dogs? He's a funny bloke, that bloke. Hooray! Somebody's here. Door is open. I see him too many times a day, that bloke. It's very strange. Anyway, chez moi. I'll, okay, fingers crossed this came out okay. It's only an experiment. I'll talk to you tomorrow, one way or the other. Bye.